What's up guys and welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while. I don't think I've posted a video in about a month. I have just been having a lot of health issues and complications lately and I haven't really been going to the gym. I have been so off my game. I've been eating like total crap and I'm just trying to get back to my normal self as possible. And I've also had a family member that was also in the hospital, so it's just been kind of a crazy month. But if you're new here, thank you guys so much for clicking on my channel. But even though I haven't really been able to work out or go to the gym, I did want to come on and do a video since I haven't posted one in a little over a month and just do a little what's in my gym bag. I have been wanting to do this video for some time now, but I am excited to do it now because I recently did get a new WOLFPAK and oh my gosh, she is so beautiful. This is like my baby, I swear. And when they came out with this color, I actually saw that they had this color in like their mini version, but they didn't have it in like their bigger sizes. So I was manifesting that they were gonna come out with this color in the 25 or 35 liter. I personally like the 35 liter size. I think it is the best size for me personally and it fits all that I want it to when I go to the gym. And I'm just in love with this freaking baby blue color. It is so freaking pretty. But I'm just gonna hop right into things. I'm just gonna kinda go by like the zipper or the pouch and just show you guys what I keep in each one of them. But as you can see on the front, I really like this bag because you can put these like little patches on them. I think it's so cute. I kind of wish they had them down here too. I think that would be so cool to just keep adding more. But I do like the little touch that you can give to it with your own patches. So I have my own veteran patch right here because I used to be in the Navy. And then the She-Wolf patch that they had on their website was really cute, so I wanted that. And then it actually, every bag comes, I think, with these two patches. The Don't Be Average, Be a Wolf, and then Trust Your Instincts. And it actually, they also have a little patch like on the top right here, and it's like their little logo as well. I will say, if you don't know anything about these bags, they are pricey. I will forewarn you about that. Even their mini like 9 liters, which I also have one of those run about $60-$70. And so the 35 liter, I want to say it was around like $125-$130 that I paid for this one. But honestly, I think they're so worth it. They are so durable and I think they keep their quality for a really long time. But overall, I do think their price is worth for what you're getting. But they do have two cup holders on each side. Usually this is filled to the brim, so I typically don't really use it. Unless it's like an upper body day where I have less stuff, I'll typically put my water bottle or my shaker cup on the side. Sometimes I'll put my phone in there as well. And then they also have clips on each side. There's two on each side, so four in total. So you can like unclip it if you wanna make more room or if you wanna condense it. I usually keep them clipped most of the time, just so everything's together. But first I'll go over what I keep in this bottom square pouch. I honestly don't have much in here. I honestly just keep my Beat headphones. These are like my bigger ones that I carry. And then honestly, I just have band-aids and tissues just in case. I like to be a prepared queen and I always like to think I'm like the mom of the group and just be prepared for whatever may happen, even though some people might find it a little bit extra. But that's really all that I keep in there. In this front mini pouch, I typically keep like my smaller things. I like to have just in case, like I have a clip in here, a hair tie, just in case I forget one. And then I do have my AirPods as well in this pouch. And then I do just like to carry my lip glosses. I don't just keep these in my gym bag. I'll obviously, if I'm going somewhere with just a purse, I'll put those in there. But I've been loving the brand Summer Fridays and their lip, what are these? Their lip butter balms. Honestly, I don't understand how these are $25 a piece. I think that's kind of ridiculous in my opinion, but I will say I do really like them, but I tend to not use them as much because I don't want them to run out because they were $25 each. And they were sold out for a long time, so I had to wait to even get these ones. But anyway, and then I also keep the popular Brazilian Crush perfume spray. This is the pistachio and salted caramel, and this smells so good. And if just one day I'm just sweating a little bit much and just want a little pick-me-up or a little spritz after I'm done with the gym or whatever the case, I like to have this in there. And then I also like to carry some hydration sticks sometimes. I'm typically not one to carry full-on supplements in my bag. I just think that's a little much. And if I were to take pre-workout or anything, I typically like to do that before I go to the gym. But if I do need a little pick-me-up, I like to have electrolytes or these little hydration sticks in my bag. This one I have right now is just the Blue Raspberry Electrolyte Hydration Stick from Raw Supplements, and I am an ambassador with them. So you can use my code JOSS to save a little bit off your purchase. And if you do use my code ever, just let me know so I can personally thank you guys. But that's pretty much it for this little pouch. And then next is the second biggest zipper pouch that I'm going to show you guys. I typically only will have like a booty band that I rarely use and my knee sleeves, just because these kind of get a little smelly and I don't like to keep it with the rest of my main stuff in the big pouch, so I will just slip them in here. Other than that, I typically don't really use this pouch as much. Moving on to the biggest pouch that they have is typically where I keep my main stuff. I'll try and show you guys a separate clip, but even when you open up this pouch, they have two separate pouches inside. So on the top, there is a zipper pouch, and then there's also another little pouch at the bottom, which can kind of be hard to get to sometimes, but I'll try my best to put like my straps in like the zipper pouch just to make it a little bit easier. So I'm just gonna take everything out and then show you guys like kind of one by one what's in here. And what I'm showing you guys, I don't always carry around with me 24/7. It depends if I'm doing upper body or hitting legs on a certain day, what I will have in my bag. So like typically on upper body day, I'm not carrying my belt or my ankle straps or, you know, my knee sleeves. Nonetheless, I'll kind of explain as I go along. So first thing I have is a band. So I will typically switch them out. For upper body days, I like to use this for assisted pull-ups, and then on lower body days for like a hack squat, mainly just for that, to be honest. But if I wanted to use it for anything else, I use this thicker one. And I'll try my best to link everything that I have in the description below, but these bands I did get from Amazon. Next, for lower body days, like I said, I will have ankle straps with me. I did have a pair before I got these, and they were also from Amazon, but these ones I have now are from Upper Gear, and they're just the black ones. These are very thick and durable. There was nothing wrong with my Amazon ones. I just thought it was time to trade up for something a little bit nicer. And then again, typically only for lower body days, I will carry a belt with me. I do have a belt from Upper Gear as well, but that one is a little bit small. I should have ordered a size up from what I had originally bought. So usually if I'm not really on a cut or anything, that one doesn't typically fit me the best. So I mainly use this one that I have from Pro Fitness. This, again, I got off of Amazon. This one is significantly bigger on me than the upper one, but I like that there's so many different adjustment holes, and it just makes it easier for when my body is, you know, going through a cut or through a bulk or maintenance, whatever else. Like, this one is my go-to, and I do like the fact that the whole thing is like thick and not skinnier in the front like the upper one is. There's nothing really wrong with that, but I do just like the fact that the thickness just makes me feel more secure when I'm lifting heavier. I will also have a plethora of different kind of straps that I want to use. These ones are from Body M. So it's Body and then EM Fitness. Again, on Amazon. And then these ones, I like that they have the thicker wrist wrap, and then they have the longer like strap right here. And then these other ones from Amazon are kind of like a VersaGrip dupe, because VersaGrips are so expensive, but These were honestly like $20 or $30 off of Amazon, and I think they're very similar to those if you are looking for a good dupe. And then I also just have a plain, like, longer wrist wraps. Sometimes I don't love that these are super long and I have to like keep twisting them multiple times, but I still love them around dumbbells. They can get kind of tricky and frustrating, but these ones are from Prozis, prozis.com, and you can use my code JOSS10 to save your purchase off with them as well. Always got to put a little plug in. But and then I also keep a pair of clips with me, barbell clips, again from Amazon. These I've had for since I think I've started lifting weights, and that's been about 2.5 years, and they still have kept their quality. And I typically like to have a pair of these in my bag, honestly, just for the plain fact I don't like wasting time or spending time trying to look for them in my gym if one's not immediately around, or I can't see where a pair is, and it's just so much easier that I can just kind of whip these out of my bag and use them and then put them back and be on my merry way. And I think these were only like $15 on Amazon, which I think is a pretty great investment for them to last a very long time, and definitely think it's worth it to carry your own pair. Last thing I have is a good old barbell pad. This one is also from Upper Gear. I love that it has like the Velcro on it. My very first one, again, was from Amazon, and there's nothing wrong with it, but I did find that since it didn't have anything like right here to secure it, that it would move on the bar when I was doing a hip thrust or other exercises. And so I do love that these ones have the Velcro to make it more secured. Now, I actually don't really put this inside of the pouch. That's why I like the clips on the side. So I'll usually unclip these and then put the barbell pad on the side like this and then clip it, and then I'll walk around like this, which it can be kind of much, but I just find that's like the easiest to do for me. But I think that's everything that I wanted to show you guys that I typically will use on a daily basis, going to the gym using my WOLFPAK, my baby. And if you guys have any questions about where I got something that I didn't mention already in the description below, please let me know. But other than that, again, I have just kind of taken a little step back from the gym. Honestly, my mental hasn't been great. I have been dealing with a lot more anxiety lately, as well as other health-related issues that's been keeping me from being able to really work out and go as hard as I used to. But other than that, I'm really trying my best to come back and be on the grind with making videos. If you guys have any video suggestions that you guys would like to see, please let me know as well in the comments. Preferably videos other than workouts, just for right now, or at least trying my hardest to get back to normal, and just trying to be able to go back to the gym and in a routine. My mental as well as like just other health stuff has kind of been in the way recently, but it won't stop me from making videos or content. I guess kind of like my inspiration or my kind of like ideas for content has just not been there. So ideas really, really help me. And just to make sure that I'm making content that you guys want to see from me. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching the video, sticking around. Please leave a like or comment in the video if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.